Here we see like 11 like flying through this wall, busting through a table. So I would like to do that.
We gotta put Niko through it today. We gotta get him comfortable in the wires.
Everything comes down to this moment.
3, 2, 1, okay!
So you're on the set of Stranger Things.
And the director calls, action!
A psychic monster levitates you in the air and hurls you into a wall. Woo. Sounds dangerous. Better leave this one for the pros, right?
Well, actually, today that's your job.
Oof, oh no. Hey, I'm Niko.
I'm Gui. I have 15 years of stunt experience in Hollywood.
Yeah, and I shoot a lot of action shorts. But I love learning about stunts.
And luckily, we have a stunt professional from the show Stranger Things coming in to show you guys the ins and outs of wire work and breakaway props. And we get to see if Niko can go punch for punch with Hollywood's best.
That's right, by the end of this episode, I'll have been levitated, hurled across the room, and hopefully survived the crash through a wall.
Niko, slow your roll, buddy. Cause the first thing we gotta do is hit him with it!
So there's actually a bunch of stunts in Stranger Things, but in particular, I have a couple scenes I want to look at that showcase some really cool wire work and some stuff getting smashed and bashed.
You do like actual real deep fakes. Mm-hmm. Today, I'm going to do a mental deep fake, and I'm putting your face all over the characters getting thrown around right now.
Oh,
that's what I'm going to be doing.
All right, looking for your inspiration, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. All right, there's the smashing. Fish. Right through the table, the DJ table. Oh, that's pretty sweet.
That was nice.
That's pretty sweet. When you wire somebody up in a harness, like when Eleven's getting thrown around, is she wearing like a rock climbing harness under her clothes? Like how are they rigging her up with that?
So you have a 50 pick harness, which is like the standard harness for most stunt performers. So we use a small shackle that connects the harness to the wire. The wire is connected to another pulley system that allows you to get picked up. So we have one set that does the job of lifting. Then there's another line that's gonna be on you that's gonna do the movement of pulling you back or forward or wherever your destination is gonna be. Sick.
That's pretty rad.
Yeah.
So I would like to do that.
Okay. What'd you love about it?
In terms of going straight back, there's something classic about like getting levitated and
blasted back.
And like right through a wall or something.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty sweet.
That's always fun.
Does it take a lot of core strength to be able to do this stuff?
Yes, it does.
Okay.
And you have to have it really tight. Having anything loose when it comes to wearing a stunt harness when doing these kind of stunts is very dangerous and can cause a lot of harm. So we fully cinch up, as we call it, and you'll have somebody, which you'll experience, which will be very fun for me, is they'll come up and be like, oh yeah, are you tight enough? Are you tight enough? Are you tight enough? You're like, you know?
Here we see like 11 like flying through this wall, busting through a table. It's super cool. I really want to learn, like, how do you build breakaways? What does it take to go through it? Does it hurt? How fast do you have to hit it?
Well, luckily, because I know that I'm not qualified, I was able to bring in the second director and stunt coordinator of Stranger Things,
really?
Hito Koda. And I know he's going to have the perfect insight to help us get what we want you to do going through breakaways and doing a cool wire gag.
Okay, well, let's go talk to him and see if he can help teach me how to not break all the rest of the bones in my body.
Yeah, don't be like me.
So we have the absolute pleasure of being joined by Hito Koda, the stunt coordinator and second unit director for both Stranger Things Season 3 and Season 4. Hito, thank you so much for taking the time to join us.
Thank you. The entire season of Stranger Things this year was, for Season 4, was just out of control with wire work. I mean, we did probably well over 100 different wire gags.
Oh, wow. We're going to be trying our own version of a wire stunt here. I'm hoping to do a scene where I get levitated and then thrown backwards through a wall. I'm hoping that maybe you could impart some of your wisdom, some of your knowledge to help us make it look really cool and help us do it safely.
Something like this through the wall. Now, okay, let me ask you this though. If he's gonna go through the wall, where is he gonna land? We're gonna see where he lands. Can
question.
He go into a pad?
Let me draw you a diagram of the set that we were thinking
okay.
of. So we have a room and it's going to be a chess table. Here's me sitting here. And here's Gui. Gui is the patient at this psychic mental facility. He lifts me up and he throws me backwards, boom, through this wall. You know, what would you do from there?
For protection back here, once you get through, mm-hmm. whether there's a box catcher back here or some big pads on the ground so he gets through and just comes down to the ground.
We're thinking it'd be like a normal wall, like an office kind of thing. Like, how would you build that? How should I set that up?
Is it gonna be set up with like drywall?
I was thinking drywall,
yeah. Yeah, drywall's good. Once you have your set piece built up and the wall is set, then you would basically score the backside of it.
You
would
cut. When you say score, you mean?
Just slicing into that drywall just so that it breaks it. You don't want it to like just be a straight line. The more X's that you do, it kind of opens and makes it look like a more busted up piece instead of one solid.
I was really hoping we could get like just a Niko.
Yeah, I'll line up on it. You can draw it.
And you put like other stuff in there, papers or whatever, so that when you do hit and it hits the wall and explodes, it just makes it bigger.
So it sounds like we should really just dress it up with like a bunch of debris. The yep. more debris, the better.
And the drywall will give it to you too. The drywall is gonna throw off a lot of dust when you break through it as well.
Well, you've given us a ton of knowledge and wisdom here to work with. The next step for us is to go and do some rehearsing.
We are gonna go up to Van Nuys and meet with my buddy Max, who has an awesome truss rigging system which allows us to practice all the wire stuff that we're gonna do on the day of the shoot. You excited?
I'm super excited. I'm ready to get on that wire. I'm ready to see what it feels like. You know, right now it's all theory, so let's go try it.
We are at the ECS Stunt Training Facility in front of this amazing structure. Max, please tell us about this.
So I put this grid in for the stunt community to come over and practice pre-viz. If they have some concepts that they want to work on or get ready for the big screen, they can come and work out all the kinks back here.
That's awesome. Hito, what exactly are we going to do today? What is our goal for Niko?
We're going to put Niko through it today. We got to get him comfortable in the wires. We'll do the levitation first, and then we'll work into the second section, which is the pullback before we marry everything together once Niko's 100% comfortable with it all.
Yeah, I'm a little worried about using muscles I've never used in my entire life today, so they'll just be barking at me in a moment. I got to make sure I warm up. It'll be cool. I'm super excited. I've always wanted to try this.
I want you to hold this just right on your hips, okay?
Okay.
You're lucky you're getting the comfy one, Niko.
Yeah. For sure.
This is how we start you.
All right, come on in.
Okay.
Right now we're picking him just from his hips and we're gonna see if we can find his center of gravity because everyone's body is a little bit differently. You ready?
Uh-huh.
All right, 3, 2, 1, up. Beautiful.
Okay.
Nice, and now I want you to try to go into Superman without flipping over. Beautiful. All right,
let's bring
him down.
That's where your core comes in, Niko.
So what we wanna do is you're gonna connect with Brandon. You two are now one. So it's really important
Beautiful.
To get in sync with him. So for what your action is gonna look like, it's gonna be like 3, 2, 1, hup, and you're gonna feel the wires pull you up.
Okay.
And that's gonna help you sync up with him. 3, 2, 1, hup.
Think cool. of your landing, how you would land if you weren't on a line, if you were just jumping down, so you can compress that landing so you don't lock your legs out.
Yeah. Copy that.
3, 2, 1, hup. Ah, superhero. All right,
Sick.
Cool. Let's
That's
do
awesome.
A little bit of travel. One, hup. Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah. So even though Brandon's giving you all this force, you're still in control of your body,
yeah.
your energy.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that was intentional. I had to make the sound effects. That was the trick.
Yeah, that was
That's usually the trick.
Now you can see the concept of how it works where you and him are one, mm-hmm. right? Because yep. if anybody's timing's off, it's going to be weird.
Yeah, because he has to feel like when I'm going to set, he's got to like set my feet around the ground, but likewise,
it
I have to feel when
works
he's...
all one.
Yeah.
So, it's a good job, though.
Thank you, man. I feel pretty cool.
Every wire gag is unique to itself. One of the most recent that I did was on Stranger Things.
Yeah.
Season 4 with the Demogorgon. That one was challenging because we did a big one-er. It was a lot of riggers, we were all hand pulls. You know, we did end up breaking it into a couple pieces and stitching it together to make it a one-er. It was one of the coolest because there was no Demogorgon there, so we would do tests, you know, without anybody there. We did it with a guy in a green suit.
Yeah.
And then just multiple takes after multiple takes. And the reason we did have to break it up was just happened to not do it multiple times and
right.
I didn't want to beat up my guys. But it was fun because we had to create stuff with a monster that wasn't there, so that was more challenging and a lot of fun to kind of put together and see how we could manipulate the guys when they're getting thrown.
Right,
the
air, and then we're playing imagination. It's
yeah,
really cool.
No, it's all good. You know, I mean, that's the fun part of rigging and the challenge that you get to figure out where these lines are gonna go to make something happen.
Nice, so
all right.
graceful.
Good tips, good tips. Beautiful. I feel like the trick is like play just a little bit. Like to let go of like the focus of like, gotta be exact for a job, and we're like, I'm just gonna have fun. Just a little bit of that, and then it all comes together.
So we got you through the introduction to wire work. Now we are getting ready to actually do the gag. What is the first setup that we're gonna do to break it apart? Because it's safer to break it apart rather than doing it all at once.
We're gonna build a system that will slowly elevate him, and then we're gonna transfer that energy to a system that moves him through the wall.
For this system, is this something where it's like, are you busting out any like special electronics, or are you just?
A lot of math, a lot of manpower.
The big challenge is we have to send Niko through a wall. It looks like Niko can float, he can flip, but I've yet to see how this rig and this system is gonna get him through some drywall. I'm hoping we can solve that today with these guys.
They'd be playing chess this way, yep. And he'll lift up and then go shoot that way.
Great. As I'm imagining the shot, it's like 4 or 5 feet from the wall.
Great.
On the start there.
Love it.
Yeah.
And does he levitate for a little while before he goes
yeah,
back?
Yeah, it's definitely an up, like, oh crap, you're controlling me, and then, yeah.
So this is a 50-pick harness. So each loop we can technically connect and put a line on, and we can hold a performer up. My favorite thing to do.
Uh-oh, Gui's here.
Double check.
Thanks for giving me a little tug job
yeah,
there.
Just to make sure, bro, a little tug job. How do you feel breathing-wise?
Good. Like. I got plenty of space to breathe.
Good.
It's all not right. Tight enough.
It's not, no.
I mean, I can't barely breathe.
Yeah.
So we're gonna lift you up, and now we're just gonna do a nice slow pull at like 20%, just to see how you feel, okay?
Okay.
3, 2, 1, action.
Sweet. Yeah, I can't wait. That's gonna be so rad busting through a drywall.
3, 2, 1. Three, two, one, up.
Keep that chin tucked down. You don't want to go and catch your head. And if you feel like you're getting the spin that way, you don't want to go head first into it either. So you want to stay balled up. It's looking good. It's going to be awesome.
Wow. That was really fun.
Was
you had
super,
a good time?
Super good time. I'm feeling great. I'm so happy.
Hell yeah. So we did everything we needed. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Max. Thank you, Hiro. And Niko, we'll see you on set.
Okay.
All right. We'll see you, buddy.
Good job.
Peace, man.
Wait. Guys. Guys. Good morning, my name is Trent Rutherford, MD. I'm a doctor, if you couldn't tell. Today's a big day. We're shooting the Stranger Things scene. It's gonna be me playing chess with a psychic telekinetic Gui. He's gonna lift me up and throw me through the wall. So we had a team come in and build a set in our studio, and then we had the rigging team come in and put up trusses and their wire systems, and we're also putting in the breakaway wall today, which is cut on both sides with a razor blade so they can break easily. I am nervous because the wall is skinnier than I thought it'd be. It's about the size of a doorway. I was expecting about the size of a double doorway. I gotta make sure I really tuck my arms and legs. I don't wanna smack the back of my head. Sam did mention he wants to send me through a only half scored wall first, which is a little bit of a change of plans. And generally I'm against changing variables on the day, but you know what? I'll be fine. That's what I keep telling myself. And I'll keep telling myself that until I go through it.
The big logistical thing in our way that will get us to our stunt is shooting the whole thing, because the stunt comes at the very end, and we can't get there until we're done filming everything else. We got a bunch of shots to get, and only until we've filmed a cohesive and good short film will we get to do the big stunt everyone's been waiting for.
What a lovely day it's been so far. It's been chill, it's been easy. I just sit here, Natalie moves the chess pieces, Gui
Just sits here
also, no dialogue. But that piece is about to be shattered, just like the wall behind me is about to be shattered. My spine will remain unshattered as I go through that wall. Gui is gonna delight in watching me finally take a big hit. A little nervous. Look, it all just comes down to Max lifting me in the air and throwing me down that line straight.
Well, that's what we're gonna test right now. Like right now we're gonna run it at 10% really slow, but we're gonna find out real soon if that's okay. We are about to do a wire gag. I'm gonna be making the calls for the stunts. This zone here, this corridor here is hot. We're literally gonna be sending a body flying through this zone. So if you could stay out of this zone here. Justin, good?
Good.
Jordan, good?
Good.
Kravik, good?
Good.
3, 2, 1, up.
That's pretty sweet looking.
That's good.
Sweet, nice work.
Niko's gone up on wires, he's gone back on wires. But there has been nothing in his path so far. So now we get to see how this actually comes together.
Running a stunt is kind of like a dance. Everybody needs to be working together and their timing needs to be perfect. This is a kind of a complicated stunt with multiple pieces, so everyone who's working on the stunt needs to find their spot and their timing.
This first thing we're gonna do is just pick you straight up. You wanna swell your chest up, otherwise you're gonna get like a tenting thing going on, and that's just where your vest pulls away from your body. Inhale and get a big breath. It's gonna make your ribs hold you up into the vest a little bit more, right?
3, 2, 1, up.
Cut. Woo! That felt super spicy. I like it, so let's move on.
Everything comes down to this moment. Niko, finally in wires, is placed for his final big stunt with moments left to live.
Hold on, never, that's not totally right.
We're gonna get you up, we're gonna set you, we're gonna double check everything, then we're gonna go.
It's like the whole day's been building up to this moment, so.
Does that screw your exposure too much?
Mark and Austin, roll cameras. I'm rolling as well.
Jordan, set.
Set.
Niko, set.
Set.
Krawick, set.
Set.
3, 2, 1, okay! Okay!
Woo! It ain't nothing!
Good?
Yeah, I'm good. Thank you so much.
That's a wrap. It's a little weird only getting one take of a shot. It's like it wouldn't have worked without going out there, getting comfortable with the rig, understanding the motions, then coming here, taking the wall down, doing a full rehearsal, like going through a wall just for fun, basically, you know?
It's strange like building up for a whole day, 2 days, honestly, if not more, for just like a 5 second moment.
That's what it's like, you know? You spend months working on something and then it's only for 15 minutes on the film.
Yeah.
But it was a magic moment, right?
Yeah, it was. The dust and the pieces of the game boards and the breaking wall, like you can't get that kind of breaking and physics and dust with the visual effects. You have to do it with practice.
Not like that, no.
Yeah.
Not like that. I'm gonna go dump this footage here. I'm gonna edit this and I'm looking forward to showing it to you guys. And I think all the build up to the stunt was worth it.
All right, I got my big stunt moment. Hopefully the video that it's in is cool because without emotional context and drama, stunts don't hit.
Here's the piece. I think it turned out pretty well. The big moment is pretty sweet.
What a waste of talent.
click that link and subscribe. Like and comment below. So what's the verdict? Did we successfully accomplish the task of making Niko go through a wall without him dying? Well, he's here, so we succeeded with that part.
Did it feel like he deserved to go through that wall?
Oh yeah.
Absolutely.
All right.
Cool.
Niko, I would have thrown you through a wall too if you were doing that to me.
The smuggest guy ever.
He's so smug, and you're not even like playing chess, you're just using a computer.
Not only did the story have the perfect setup, I think, to be ready to see that happen, but the payoff was equal to the setup before it.
Like, it looks so good because you get the actual practical, like, actor pulled through the wall. It's not just like a CG wall exploding. You get all the baby powder exploding off the shelf, so. It's stuff like that that really elevates a piece like this.
I suppose if you were to try to do like the wall CG, you wouldn't get the reaction of my body hitting it.
Yeah.
You know, that slight shockwave that happens as I go through it. Are there any bits of wisdoms or lessons you learned from Hiro at the end of the day?
So I'm sitting there like watching the rigs being built. I walked over to Hiro and said, this is really cool, but I'm really curious as to like how this is gonna work in our studio. Like as I was speaking with him, he was like describing basically how the actual rig works. It's just like a little bit of truss and some wire work.
But, so a little bit of trust.
Yeah.
And a little bit of trust.
Trust in the truss. I was really amped to do this one because like I love the Stranger Things vibe. You know, I like the retro stuff. I have this whole kit of these vintage lenses that sit around getting dust. And so I'm like, heck yes, finally. More, you know, retro cinema stuff. I'm obviously a huge fan. So every shot, even the simple ones with just like little close-ups and stuff and building up to it, it was all super fun.
This also reinforced for me how a lot of what happens on camera is actually really simple. It's just the coordination and time going into it and then the context around it. It's about the craft and about telling a cool story and having a cool moment. And when you add that into it, everything gets elevated.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Everybody, this is the first episode of Punch for Punch and we have more coming out. So make sure you are subscribed to Still Watching Netflix here on YouTube and leave a comment telling us what other Netflix shows you would like us to break down the stunts to.
We got Witcher, we got Day Shift, we got Cobra Kai on the way. So click that subscribe button and we'll see you next time.